Hey, have you ever spent an hour in meetings just to figure out who's doing what? Or scroll through a ton of email chains just to find a single file? That's why teams at NASA used Asana to coordinate their Mars rover missions, and Uber has used it to launch in 600 cities all at once. If it can handle that kind of complexity, imagine what it can do for your work. Hey, welcome back. For our newcomers, we are all about making project management click. In the last video, we learned about Six Sigma, but we're gonna shift our focus from project management principles to project tools. Now, this video marks the beginning of a short series on various project management systems. And today, we're going to take a look at Asana, a powerful yet intuitive platform that could transform your workflow. So what is Asana? Well, if you've never heard of it, it's a cloud-based platform, and it's been designed to help teams organize, track, and manage their work. It was actually founded by Facebook co-founder Dustin Moskovitz and former Facebook engineer Justin Rosenstein. And it was built to solve a problem that they experienced firsthand. And that was teams wasting tremendous amount of time coordinating work rather than doing it. Now today, Asana serves over 130,000 paying customers, from small startups to global enterprises like Google, Amazon, and Netflix. But what makes it so widely adopted? Well, have a look at it. It's super intuitive, and it's got this great friendly interface combined with powerful functionality. Unlike traditional project management tools that often feel rigid and complex, Asana strikes a great balance between simplicity and capability. So whether you're a marketing team coordinating campus campaigns across your university, or you're a product team tracking feature development, or maybe you're a professional services team managing client deliverables, it really doesn't matter, because Asana adapts to your workflow rather than you being forced to adapt to it. So let's look at some really key features of Asana, and I think you'll see why Asana is so effective. First, at its most basic level is task management. It helps you break down all your work into actionable tasks. And these tasks have a ton of fields that you can fill out, including your descriptions, dates, times, assignees, priority levels, custom fields. You can even attach files. Matter of fact, National Geographic plans every social post in Asana with visuals, their copy, and the approvals attached. Now you go a step up from that and you start looking at your project view as a whole. Now, one of Asana's most powerful features is its ability to display the same work in different formats. So there's a more traditional task list with your list view for straightforward tracking. There's also a board view, like a Kanban style board, for visual workflow management. And there's also a timeline view, like a Gantt chart. Remember when we talked about waterfall and traditional? Well, Gantt chart is one of those views that you use in waterfall project management. And Asana supports that for scheduling and dependencies and all this other kind of stuff that you use it for. There's also a calendar view, which is a date-based visualization for time-sensitive work. You know, the Girl Scouts actually use the timeline view to manage their nationwide cookie sales. Now, another thing that makes Asana really powerful is their automation. You can automate routine aspects of your work, like automatically assigning tasks based on your project role. You can move tasks between sections when their status changes, and you can send notifications when deadlines approach. You can even create recurring tasks for regular work. And if that weren't enough, Asana also has a ton of third-party integrations, like Microsoft Office 365, Google Workspace and their suite of software, communication tools like Slack and Teams. You can even tie in Adobe Creative Cloud and tools like GitHub and Bitbucket. You know, Deloitte actually integrated Asana with Slack and Google Drive to cut out a ton of miscommunication. And here's your pro tip. Just start with something small. Create a project called Waiting On, let's say. And anytime you delegate something, put it in there. That way, you'll never lose track of any deliverables associated with these things. You'll always know what you're waiting for and who you need to connect with. So how do we get started with Asana? Well, honestly, it's really easy. You start small. Begin with one project rather than migrating everything all at once. And then work on designing your workflow. You want to start to map out your process before building it in Asana. And then you also want to train your champions. You want to identify team members who can help others adopt the tool. You might also want to schedule regular reviews. So these are going to be regular check-ins to refine your Asana setup. And then also connect your integrations early. Because once you have your integrations and your workflow set up and your configured setup with your most used tools, well, then you're going to be able to start getting the most benefit from it from day one. If this already looks like it could unclog your workflow, hit that like button so more people discover this video. And let me know in the comments, what is one recurring task that you would love to be able to automate using Asana? So to kind of put a tidy little bow on all of this, remember NASA uses Asana for their missions. Surely it would work great to plan your next team project because it provides the structure needed to turn all of that project chaos into clarity. So whether you're managing your complex projects or simply trying to organize your personal tasks more effectively, Asana's balance of power and simplicity makes it worth looking into. In our next video, we'll dive into another powerful tool called Monday, and we'll see how it compares. If you found this video helpful, please do me a huge favor and share it and click that like button. Don't forget to subscribe so you get notified when that Monday.com video comes out next. Hey, I appreciate you watching, and I'll catch you in the next.